In this demo, we will have a look at the sequence alignment and clustering tools in the BioNumerics Comparison window. The database we will use contains a set of bacterial strains that are characterized by a number of techniques. The left panel contains a list of the database entries, which are the bacterial strains that are characterized by the information fields. Before we create a cluster analysis, we will make a selection of the entries we want to cluster. For this example, I will simply select all the entries in the database using the shortcut Ctrl+A. I create a new comparison by pressing the left button in the Comparisons panel. The comparison window is the basis for most of the comparative functions of the software, including cluster analysis, principal components analysis, classification, identification, sequence alignments, and phylogeny. The entries are listed in the panel Information Fields. There is also a panel Experiment Data, where the experimental data can be displayed. In case of sequence experiments, it will display the nucleotide or amino acid sequences. The experiments available in this database are displayed in the upper left panel, the Experiments panel. To display the sequences for the 16S ribosomal RNA genes, I click on the icon left from the experiment name. The vertical zoom slider allows me to zoom in or out on the sequences. Below a given zoom level, the bases are shown as colored squares, which can be a useful representation in case of large alignments. Note that the sequences are unaligned in first instance. To obtain a multiple alignment, I press the Align button in the Experiment Data panel. In the dialog box that appears, I am allowed to adjust the alignment settings. There is an open gap penalty, which is the cost to create a single gap in a sequence. The cost is relative to the score for one matching base. There is also a unit gap penalty, which is the cost to increase a gap with one single position. The value you will want to enter here depends on the type of sequences you are analyzing. For example, if you know that recombinations, insertions, and deletions are the most common sort of mutations, you will probably want to set this penalty to zero. The right side of the dialog box allows us to choose the algorithm. If you uncheck Fast Algorithm, the algorithm applied is the method described by Myers and Miller. In the Fast Algorithm, bases can be grouped into words to speed up the calculations. The higher this number, the faster but less sensitive the alignment will be. Also, the number of possible frame shifts to consider can be entered. A lower number of frame shifts or gaps results in faster calculations. I leave the settings to their defaults and press OK. Now the sequences are nicely aligned and the UPGMA tree is automatically calculated. Let us first make it a little bit easier to interpret this alignment. First of all, I create a consensus sequence, which is a computed sequence that contains all bases that are present in a defined percentage of the sequences in my alignment. First, I click on the root of the tree. Then I click on the sequence menu and select Create Consensus of Branch. Note that you can also create a consensus of any selection of sequences in the alignment, not necessarily a branch. I am now prompted to enter a minimum consensus percentage. The default value of 50% results in a majority consensus, which is OK for my example. I press the OK button to calculate the consensus. The consensus is now written in the header on top of the alignment. Every position in the alignment for which less than 50% of the sequences have the same base is represented by N. Now I can highlight the differences in the alignment by displaying shaded blocks. I select Sequence, Block Type, and Consensus Difference. Now only the bases that are different from the consensus are displayed. When I select Sequence, Block Type, and Consensus Blocks, those bases that correspond to the base in the consensus are now displayed on a dark background block. If you want to learn how to edit multiple alignments and create phylogenetic trees, we invite you to view our other movies.